We've been deluged.
Sleep if they come on too late. I have always loved The Who, partly because their name was easy to pronounce, and partly because the band's music seemed to embody the very spirit of rock and roll. Last year, they embarked on their farewell tour, their second farewell tour, in fact, and I'm sure we'll be seeing their third farewell tour sometime in the mid-90s, but I am not complaining. A double live album titled Joined Together is being released as a memento of the concerts and includes, among other treats, the first complete live version of Tommy. We talked with Pete Townshend, who is recording a new solo album, although for Pete even Who albums are solo albums, and then Roger Daltrey, who is surprising everyone, especially Sting and David Bowie, by becoming a respected actor, and lastly, John Entwistle, who is writing a Who biography with the working title Keep Your Dead Job. A very good idea indeed, The Who for Rapido.
Good afternoon. You come this way? Tea cakes? Muffins? Some nostalgias? Sentimental reminiscences? Go back in time through history? To when music was really music? People were really people?
Face Dancers, released 9 years ago, was supposed to be The Who's farewell album, so their brand new live set, Joined Together, is something of a bonus for the fans. But Pete Townshend, for one, hasn't been too involved.
I haven't decided anything about this album. I didn't have anything to do with the running order. I didn't choose the producer. I didn't pick the record cover. I'm happy that the album is there, but I've had very little to do with the conception of it. I suppose Tommy was included really because of public interest. The band got together because of public interest, because people wanted us to. I think it captures the atmosphere of the band on the tour, and I think it was certainly worth doing the album because the event was a one-off. It won't happen again.
Cynics might argue that the album, like the band's world tour, is just a money-making exercise, perhaps to help pay the mortgage on bassman John Entwistle's home in Ireland.
I know the Stones said that we were going to do it for the money, but, I mean, did they do it for free? No, nobody works for nothing. I mean, we did a lot of charity gigs on this tour, you know, so we gave some of the money back. But The Who have always been like... Being in The Who has always been like winning the football pools and not bothering the cash to check in.
Last year saw the Stones competing with The Who for the hard-earned savings of America's more senior concert-goers. Roger Daltrey has nothing but respect for his old rivals.
I admire them for doing what they do. Yeah. I really do admire them. I think they're a great band. And I love the fact that they don't give a toss. They say, we'll be doing this when we're... Or we'll be trying to do this when we're 60, just like the old blues players. I wish I was that satisfied with being a rock singer. I'm not, I'm afraid. There's too many other things I want to do.
Tommy, can you see me? Can I help to cheer you? Oh.
Roger must have made a bob or two from the healthy string of acting jobs he's had, not to mention the advertising. So he obviously rejects the accusation that The Who only reformed for the bucks.
You could not do that job just for the money. It's too hard, and what you have to get out of yourself, you couldn't do it just for the money. Like, not being in The Who anyway. It's too demanding. It really is. You could only do it if you love it. I don't know whether you could do it if you love it and not getting paid for it. No, that takes a bit of thinking about.
Back in Galway, John Entwistle is busy writing a biography of The Who. He promises a different approach to previous accounts.
When I think back of The Who, and I think about Keith Moon, I think about all the fun we had and all the messes we got into. And I think that's a lot more entertaining reading than a serious, straight-laced sort of history. Most of the writers about The Who make the mistake of trying to dissect what we were about, and they, unless they were standing on stage playing, they got no idea.
Last year's tour marked the band's 25th birthday. Their music may have changed a lot since the early days, but their internal politics remain much the same.
I don't think the other two had changed at all. They're exactly the same. When we put the band together again, we had the same problems as when we broke up. You know, we all had completely different musical tastes still. You know, nothing had actually been solved from the day we broke up. You know, all the problems were still there. We still had to find a way of dealing with them. You know. Roger still thought I was too loud, you know, Pete still couldn't hear properly.
What this Who tour was to me was a part of my solo career. That's how I see it, as just a part of my career. The, you know, the band that we used was my band. And Roger and John kind of guessed it. And although we did some of John's songs and... I mean, that sounds unbelievably big-headed, but I mean, I wouldn't have done it if I felt that I was going to be drawn into another world that I couldn't handle again. Do you know what I mean? Because it's taken me such a long time since The Who to just find myself.
From the granddaddies of rock to the preppy.